Hello, my name is Jared Hybart. I am a product manager here at Yokogawa, and today we'll be covering common maintenance items for the FC800D. The first maintenance item we're going to cover today is how to clean your flow cell and change or clean the measurement beads. For the cell maintenance, you'll need a Phillips head screwdriver, a soft bristle toothbrush, a container to place your beads in, as well as some either soapy water or a dilute hydrogen chloride solution to help clean the beads. For cleaning the flow cell, the first thing we will do is put the analyzer into maintenance mode. You can do this by pressing the maintenance button on the home screen, clicking yes, and then also turning off the measurement electrode. You have a measurement electrode button on the home screen. You press this button, hit yes, and the motor will stop. With the analyzer in maintenance mode and the measurement electrode turned off, we can undo the two screws at the bottom of the flow cell. These are captive screws, so they'll stay with the flow cell. You can lift the electrode assembly off and put it into maintenance position, which is where these two slots to the right of the flow cell are and align with the two pins on the measurement assembly. With the electrode assembly in the maintenance position, this gives you access to the flow cell. First thing we want to do is remove the bead container. You can do this by grabbing on to the small rubber piece next to the bead basket and pulling straight up. This will remove the entire bead basket. With the bead basket removed, you can place your beads into a separate container for cleaning or disposal. Now that the flow cell is empty, you can take a soft toothbrush and some mild detergent, or in extreme cases, some hydrochloric acid, and begin to rinse and scrub the flow cell. Especially make sure that the inlet, as well as the measurement and the reference areas, are clean. Once the flow cell is clean to your standards, you want to make sure that you rinse it with clean water to get rid of any extra detergent, and then we can install the new beads. If you're cleaning the beads, you have a couple of options for cleaning. You can either use just a mild detergent and clean water to clean the beads, and then the same toothbrush you use to clean the cell, you can use to mix the beads up and help get rid of any buildup on them. For dirtier beads, we recommend using a dilute HCl solution and letting them sit for 30 minutes to an hour. And then you can take that toothbrush and mix it up and knock off any remaining buildup. Once you are satisfied with how clean the beads are, you will want to rinse them multiple times with clean water to make sure you get rid of either any detergent that's still on them or any HCl on the beads. When putting the beads back into the basket, it is best to put a little bit of water in the container because it will allow them to flow more easily into the basket. If you're using fresh beads, you can put these new beads into the bead basket and then press the bead basket back into the flow cell so that the rubber piece that you use to pull the bead basket out is facing the inlet. Once you have replaced or cleaned your beads and cleaned your flow cell, you can move the measurement electrode assembly back to the measurement position, tighten down the two screws on the bottom, make sure that the motor is turning, and put the analyzer back into measurement mode. Thank you for watching. If you have any questions or would like more information, please contact us at yca-support@yokogawa.com.